Here's another poem for or about my wife. It's called Foresee. It's a poem about lovers who part or do not part. And the poem begins with three pairs of lovers who separate, and then it ends with my wife and me who did not. After the clash of elevator gates and the long sinking, she emerges where a slight thing in the morning's crosstown glare, she looks up toward the window where he waits. Then in a fleeting taxi joins the rest of the huge traffic bound forever west. On such grand scale do lovers say goodbye. Even this other pair whose high romance had only the duration of a dance, and who, now taking leave with stricken eye, see each in each a whole new life foregone. For them, above the darkling clubhouse lawn, bright Perseids flash and crumble. While for these who part now on the dock, weighed down by grief and baggage, yet with something like relief, it takes 3,000 miles of knitting seas to cancel out their crossing and unmake the amorous rough and tumble of their wake. We are denied, my love, their fine tristesse and bittersweet regrets, and cannot share the sweet frequent vistas of their large despair, where love and all are swept to nothingness. Still, there's a certain scope in that long love which constant spirits are the keepers of, and which, though taken to be tame and staid, is a wild sostenuto of the heart, a passion joined to courtesy and art, which has the quality of something made, like a good fiddle, like the rose's scent, like the rose window or the firmament. I think that there are various possible ways of describing poetry, but one thing that's almost always true of it, as opposed to prose, is that its words are working very hard with each other. The words of poems work harder with each other than the words of most prose can do. And I do think there's an instance of that at the end of this poem. It's rather a lot to have a love poem soar into the firmament and have firmament be its last word. And I think if I do get away with it, I do, because firmament is balanced by something as modest and earthly as a good fiddle,